My name is Mohammed Aram, and on behalf of my co-host, Ms. Mike Bile, I welcome you all to the awards night, where we celebrate the achievements of our graduating cohort. I would like to invite on stage Sayyid Fazlur Rahman from the batch of 2020 for the recitation of the Holy Quran.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم اقرأ باسم ربك الذي خلق خلق الإنسان من علق اقرأ وربك الأكرم الذي علم بالقلم علم الإنسان ما لم يعلم.
Translation: In the name of Allah, the most gracious, the most merciful. Recite in the name of your Lord, who created man from a clinging substance. Recite, and your Lord is the most generous, who taught by the pen, taught man that which he knew not.
Sadaqallahu al-Azim.
Jazakallah. Ladies and gentlemen, the words by Robert Frost, "I took the road less traveled by, and that has made all the difference," resonate with me tonight as we gather here to celebrate and honor the achievements of a graduating batch. The co-founder batch is unique, as they were the first one who took the road less traveled. And what an amazing journey it has been, filled with struggles and new experiences. Over the course of 4 years, the class of 2018 has proven that the students of Habib University do not shy from challenges. Tonight, we celebrate the achievements, and we were so excited to do so that we could not even wait for another 22 hours to welcome them.
Here at Habib, we pride ourselves on the shared and close sense of community. And for that, we are truly grateful to our co-founders and our amazing faculty, as they are the ones for inculcating this culture. It is also the reflection of the beauty of a liberal arts institution, where there is no separation based on one's major or program. So tonight we have with us engineers that are excellent at designing and philosophers that use their knowledge of computer science to search for answers. And this would not have been possible without the liberal core. Whenever we hear the words liberal core, one person comes to our mind. He has been an inspiring mentor for the entire student body, and I take immense pride in welcoming to the stage the Director of Comparative Liberal Studies, Dr. Noman Naqvi.
Distinguished Chancellor, President, Governors, Directors, Colleagues, Students, Ladies and Gentlemen, Assalamu Alaikum, Good Evening, Adab. It is fitting that I begin this set of convocational festivities by immediately congratulating you on this auspicious milestone for our community. Habib University, congratulations. May the merciful God increase our blessings. Ameen. I congratulate all of the Habib University community, and mashallah, it is already a long list. So not all of you are present. Faculty, administration, staff, sponsors, donors, trustees, directors, many colleagues in the academy globally, and friends everywhere. But I congratulate above all, on behalf of this community, the people we are here to celebrate, the students, the graduating class of 2018. Co-founders, you have prevailed, and we are so very proud of you. Congratulations. May you succeed beyond and beyond our and even your own wildest dreams, which, given how crazy you are, is asking the generous Lord for a lot. How you've grown in these four extraordinary years, in these extraordinary times. You were already distinctive. That is what brought you here to begin with. What made you make this remarkable wager. That's what it was. But the mark has matured. You came here because, apart from a purely functional degree, you were thoughtful and wanted to cultivate your thoughtfulness. In our times, this is an extraordinary desire and the most difficult and demanding of all endeavors. You persevered, and having given yourself to this most authentic of human tasks, you have grown. You have grown in grace, in sobriety, in distinction. We've all been a witness to this. Many of you are already beginning to make a mark beyond the brief borders of Habib, but all of you bear about you the mark of a certain restraint and sobriety, a certain inward discipline that is necessary for excellence as much as for generosity and gracefulness. These are the three immediate connotations of Yosin, which is what I'm to speak about this evening. Ehsan, Ehsan, and Husn. In these dark and difficult times, you, the class of 2018, are a sight for sore eyes. Bless you. May the world welcome and benefit from your light. In the harsh daylight of our global culture of success and celebrity today, it is easy to forget that though such moments on the stage of life are significant, most of all of our lives are lived in anonymity. And it is the practice, to the best of our abilities, of these qualities of Yosin, that brings a measure of luminosity to our everyday world. May you and we all have the blessing and the strength to practice Yosin better, and may your gentle light ever increase. Ameen. You were not the only ones brought here to Habib University by a certain longing. People to whom the word of Yosin spoke, this word we have inherited from Imam Ali. So many of us in the Habib community are assembled here for our university's singular mission and vision. The early German romantic philosopher Novalis, among others, has spoken of the relation between longing and philosophy. So many of the Habib faculty I have spoken to were also brought here by this thoughtful desire. For my part, Habib University was a second chance at such a wager. In the early 90s, the late Dr. Iqbal Ahmed, who many of you, no doubt, perhaps all of you know, had returned to Pakistan from his long sojourn in the United States to create a liberal arts college in Islamabad. I had just graduated from a liberal arts college myself and moved to Islamabad to be close to him and participate in the project in some way. For reasons that are now a part of history, that project did not, alas, come to pass. Perhaps its proposed location was inauspicious. Habib University in Karachi was a real chance, and its project went much further. Habib University was born out of a deepening sense of the cognitive and pedagogical crisis to which Iqbal had wanted to respond, and Habib's response to that crisis was even more generous of thought, even more post-colonial in potential than what Iqbal had envisioned. Up to this moment, we are all founding faculty here, the faculty present here, my colleagues. We are all founding faculty here, and I am deeply proud of my distinguished colleagues in the School of Science and Engineering and the School of Arts, Humanities, and Social Sciences, who first of all know a good wager when they see one. An essential quality in today's precarious world and who have the conviction, commitment, intelligence, and gumption to make their impossible dreams real. Habib University's pedagogical mission rests above all on the transformative commitment to undergraduate teaching. Allow me to let this airplane pass. Habib University's pedagogical mission rests above all on the transformative commitment to undergraduate teaching, a purpose that is increasingly under assault on today's educational scene. The faculty has grown fast and large in these brief years, so unfortunately it is not possible to name all of you, the founding faculty, for the remarkable work that you have done to get us all here. But allow me to congratulate all of you together in the School of Science and Engineering and the School of Arts, Humanities and Social Sciences. Distinguished colleagues, to you too, congratulations. There's a long way to go, but look how far we've come. In the midst of a cynical and enervating world, you too have prevailed. On behalf of the Habib community, please accept our deepest gratitude and once again, congratulations. May the divinity increase our commitment and discipline and multiply our knowledge and insight. Ameen. The commitment to the noble cause of Yosin that we celebrate today, the regularity, discipline, initiative, and persistence that have borne this fruit also belong in large measure to the staff and administration of Habib University. As all of us here by now know, and to put it with some understatement, it is not easy to start and move forward a new university. In the measure of the extraordinary and extraordinarily difficult initiatives undertaken by humans, this has got to be up there. A university is in some ways the most impossible of communities. And it is no doubt for this reason that a specially demanding ethos of collegiality has been imposed upon it. Add to this the baffling nature of starting a new one from scratch under imposing constraints, and it is enough to drive one bonkers, really, or break one's back, a real possibility. Much of the credit for keeping our back straight during this ferocious 4-year stint that has brought us so far in such little time goes to the administration and staff, some of whom are among my best friends in the Habib community. You know who you are, but all of whom inspire respect, even affection in my heart. This graduation is thanks to you as much as anybody else. Congratulations, congratulations. May you be rewarded 1,000 times. Ameen. The Habib University community has also been singularly blessed with distinguished national and international partners, patrons, and benefactors who have shown a remarkable commitment and enthusiasm for the Habib pedagogical mission. Their gracious counsel, support, and gratis work and governance of the university has played a key role in how well the task of shaping futures has gone these past 4 years. To the board of directors and governors, and once again, on behalf of the Habib community, this journey would really not have been possible without you. A very special and deep thanks and the heartiest congratulations to you too. My own personal experience with you has largely been limited to the meeting rooms of the Academic Committee of the Board of Governors. Your generosity, grace, and insight illuminate these rooms in my memory. May you be blessed. Ameen. I have sometimes thought that it may well be, inshallah, that in the modern history of pedagogical enterprises by subcontinental Muslims, Habib University will have a significance similar to Jamia Millia, whose pedagogical mission was to root higher education and knowledge in a more indigenous perspective that was at once global in its reach. In creating the conditions of possibility for the Habib University project, the Habib family has made not just a national contribution that is continuous with its inheritance,
but a genuinely global contribution to the cause of higher education. How can we thank you? Congratulations on this first entirely metaphorical return on your crazy investment. It takes boldness and generosity of vision to initiate such a venture. Maula ajar de, Ameen. I cannot end this speech without congratulating singularly the extraordinary character who in many ways has borne and continues to bear a great share of the burden of steering this remarkable journey through wild terrain. I heard one of our partners at Texas A&M describe him as Wild Man Wasif, which has for some reason, I don't know, stuck in my head. Our distinguished president has got to be among the most interesting occupants of that office in any higher educational institution. You're never going to hear it from me again, but for this one occasion, I really don't know anyone who could have done it or done it like this with such style. Congratulations, Mr. President. May you get to go on ziyarat as often as possible, which is a pretty qualified dua, I know, but we need you here, and if I said as often as you want, and that was granted, we all know what would happen. Let me end by again turning to the co-founders. As faculty, it is easy to forget how hard it is to learn, even though we should know instinctively, since it only gets harder with time. Throw in with that innate difficulty of the task what is one of the most avant-garde and demanding curricula out there, and you have a measure of what you have been put through these past four relentless years. Daame har mauj mein hai halka-e sadgaam nahang, dekhein kya guzre hai katre pe gohar hote tak. Zara dekhiye in heroon ki taraf, subhanallah. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the class of 2018 Habib University's co-founders. Badai ho, mubarak ho. And now it gives me great pleasure to turn to the next part of this evening's festivities, Qawwali ki mehfil. Qawwals are literally preservers of our inheritance, our miras, and are living evidence of the everyday and popular enjoyment of mystical and philosophical reflection in our inheritance. At Habib University, every year, we commence with a Qawwali performance, and from now, it will also end with a Qawwali performance too at convocation. At this, our first convocation, it is our fortune and privilege to have with us the great Qawwals, the Sami brothers. Though they need no introduction, Sami brothers ka taluk mausiki ke jis khanwade se hai, wo barre sagir paak o hind mein kisi taaruf ka mohtaj nahi. Is khandan ko Qawwal Bacha Gharana ya Tanras Khan Sahib ke Delhi Gharane ke naam se yaad kiya jata hai. Ye wo wahid gharana hai jise Hazrat Amir Khusro ki shagirdgi ka sharaf hasil hai. Inke jad Mian Samad, jo ke Hazrat Amir Khusro ki mausiki ke wahid amin aur waris the, khayal aur qawwali ke bhi. Sami brothers ne mausiki ki ibtidai taleem apne walid Nasiruddin Sami Sahib se hasil ki, اور اس کے بعد اپنے نانا سے موسیقی کی یکسوئی کے ساتھ تعلیم حاصل کی. ان کے نانا ہم سب کو یاد ہیں منشی رضی الدین صاحب تھے جو کہ موسیقی میں ایک اونچا مقام رکھتے ہیں. پاکستان اور پاکستان سے باہر پوری دنیا میں پاکستان کی نمائندگی کرتے ہیں اور اپنی روایتی قوالی کی وجہ سے دنیا میں بے پناہ مشہور ہیں. خواتین و حضرات, سامی برادرین قوال.
Hello. Hello. Samay Nigram, Adab. Aaj is khushi ke mauke pe Wasif sahab ne aur unke team ne hame yaad kiya aur Numan bhai उसमें बीच में हमारे साथ थे, तो मैं बहुत शुक्रगुजार हूँ। और कव्वाली के लिए हमें टाइम कुछ मुख्तसर है, तो जो कुछ हमसे हो सकता है पेश करते हैं। समाअत फरमाइए, साज़िने से महफिल का आगाज़ कर रहे हैं। साज़िना की जाती है, तो वहां हो नहीं सकता कि मौला के नाम के बगैर कव्वाली शुरू की जाए। तो समाअत कीजिए कौल मन कुंतु मौला। कमी है लेकिन ऑल सामी ब्रदर्स का स्पेशलिटी है, तो उस पर जरा मैं तवज्जो चाहता हूँ थोड़ी आपसे।
Oh
क्या बात है। اوصاف علی اوصاف علی 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 بگفتگو ممکن نیست
اوصاف علی
کیا بات
اوصاف علی گفتگو ممکن
اوصاف علی بگفتگو ممکن نیست بن جاؤ اس بحر در صبح ممکن نیست
گنجائش بحر در صبح ممکن اوصاف علی بگفتگو ممکن نیست گنجائش بحر در صبح ممکن نیست
من ذات علی
من ذات علی 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 علی
کیا بات
من ذات علی بواج بھی کیدانم
الا دانم من ذات علی بواج بھی کیدانم الا دانم کہ مثلے ہو ممکن نیست میں
مشکل کشائے شیر یزدان نے
علی مرتضی مشکل کشائے شیر یزدان نے
ولی حق وصی مصطفی دریائے فیضان نے
ولی حق وصی مصطفی دریائے فیضان
نے امام دو جہاں نے قبلہ دین و ایمان نے
امام دو جہاں نے قبلہ دین و ایمان نے
پیغمبر بر سر منبر نشستو خواند مولا یش
پیغمبر بر سر منبر نشستو خواند مولا یش
کہ تا مولا یش را باشد اندر خلق برهان مولا علی مولا مولا
مقصود کائنات
یہی تو پانچ ہے
مقصود کائنات
بیدم یہی تو پانچ ہے
مقصود کائنات
بیدم یہی تو پانچ ہے
مقصود کائنات
خیر النساء حسین حسن مصطفی علی
مولا علی مولا مولا
ساری جنت میں رسول ازلی لکھا ہے
ساری جنت میں رسول ازلی لکھا ہے
ڈالی ڈالی پہ علی اور ولی لکھا ہے
ڈالی ڈالی پہ علی اور ولی لکھا ہے
سبز پتوں پہ حسن اور کلی پر زہرا
سبز پتوں پہ حسن اور کلی پر زہرا
پھولوں پہ حسین ابن علی لکھا ہے
پھولوں پہ حسین ابن علی لکھا
ہے دم یہی تو پانچ ہے مقصود کائنات
دم یہی تو پانچ ہے مقصود کائنات
خیر النساء حسین حسن مصطفی علی مولا
علی مولا مولا علی مولا
علی
जज्बात में बहने वाले
बने सूफी हो
अरे हो
बने सूफी
हो बने सूफी
हो
अरे हो बने सूफी
जज्बात में बहने वाले
कलम दर बने इश्क में चलने वाले
कलम दर बने इश्क में चलने
वो तब बन गए रंग जो हम सहने वाले
सारे
वली बन गए
शाली
सहने वाले
अली माला माला
वली
माला
वो तब बन गए रहे जो हम सहने वाले
तब बन गए रंग जो हम सहने
हमने तो भूतराव को खैबर पुशा कहा
तो भूतराव को हमने तो भूतराव को खैबर पुशा कहा
हमने तो भूतराव को खैबर पुशा कहा
हमने तो भूतराव को खैबर पुशा कहा
अब उनसे पूछिए कि जिन्होंने खुदा कहा
उनसे पूछिए कि जिन्होंने खुदा कहा
वाइज अली के बारे में हमसे न बहस कर
वाइज अली के बारे में हमसे
वाइज
अली के बारे में हमसे न बहस कर
हमने तो जो रसूल के मुंह से सुना कहा माला
अली माला
हरे आयात तुझे जान गए
अली मज़हरे आयात अली मज़हरे आयात तुझे जान गए
या अली 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 मज़हरे आयात तुझे जान गए हद से गुजरे तुम सैरी तो खुदा मान गए
गुजरे तुम सैरी तो खुदा मान गए
लाख डाले तेरी तस्वीर पे पर्दे लेकिन
बगैर हुब अली मुद्दा नहीं मिलता
बगैर हुब अली मुद्दा
मिलता
बात तो कभी हर किस सुना नहीं मिलता
बगैर हुब्बे अली मुद्दा नहीं मिलता इबादतों का भी हरगिज सिला नहीं मिलता
खुदा के बंदो सुनो गौर से खुदा की कसम
खुदा के बंदो सुनो गौर से खुदा
वक्त की शॉर्टेज है इंशाल्लाह आइंदा कभी आऊंगा तो इसको पूरा करूंगा सफर तवील है सफर तवील है राह निजात छोटी है
सफर तवील है राह निजात छोटी है
अली का जिक्र बड़ा अली का जिक्र बड़ा कायनात छोटी है
अली का जिक्र बड़ा कायनात छोटी है
अली को क्यों ना मैं मौला ए कायनात कहूँ
अली को क्यों ना मैं मौला ए कायनात
Ali,
Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali, Ali,
चलाव तेरे पलन हमेशा
बहुत शुक्रिया सामी ब्रादरान का, जिनकी दिल को छू जाने वाली कव्वाली ने हम सबको बहुत मुतासिर किया।
अस्सलाम वालेकुम। सो यू नो माय डिसऑर्गेनाइजनेस एंड माय लैक ऑफ राइटिंग अ स्पीच सेव्ड मी बिकॉज इट वाज इम्पॉसिबल टू फॉलो व्हाट वी जस्ट विटनेस्ड। सो हाउ अबाउट अनदर राउंड ऑफ अप्लॉड फॉर द हिप्नोटिक कव्वाली। So much to your relief, co-founders and board and other guests, I don't have a speech. There's no paper. So it's there isn't there. But let me start by just resonating all the congratulations and Mubarakbad and thank you and just the elation and the joy of graduating our first class. Well done, co-founders. Well done. You've made us proud. And three key communities, of course, the community of the founding faculty, which is about 60-some large now. Thank you. We are humbled that you took a chance at a new university and cultivated these students so beautifully. Thank you, faculty. So two other groups walked hand in hand, actually essentially pulled this university from basically an idea to what it is right now. So our board of directors, Habib University Foundation's board of directors, and many of them are here, who are dear personal friends over the course of this journey, but have helped in so many ways that I won't be able to describe, even if I had the length of the qawwali. But thank you, board of directors. Thank you. And last, not really, second, penultimate, it's the Board of Governors. Wonderful friends, we have been working at it since 2009. First meeting was August of 2010. But what a beautiful 8-year journey it has been. Thank you, Governors. But right at the last is the group, is the family, the clan that had this dream. Which is the Habib family, right? So all of it, this university bears this name, which is a strong signal that they are the ones who have coalesced and who have convened this beautiful community. So very humbly, thank you, Habib family. So with this, I'm just going to share 2.5 stories. So it is somewhat telling that we are at the 113th year, almost exactly to the date of the first story, which is the birth of Muhammad Ali Habib, father of Mr. Rafiq Habib. I was just told, I just took out this date of birth, 15th of May, if I'm 1905, and today is close to that date, 113 years on. Many of you may have seen on the wall of Mohsenin that really mystical image which says the founding family. That is the image of Mr. Muhammad Ali Habib. Now in his short 54 years, this is the first story on this planet. He witnessed two world wars, perhaps the most rapid transition of the world in the history of humankind of the last million or whatever years, and migrated from his ancestral home in Mumbai to a new country, talk about a wager no man, in Karachi. So this is the first story, and the way story blossomed, that as legendary and as successful he was as a businessman, as an entrepreneur, as a banker, he was a lot more. As a matter of fact, that was just the tip of the iceberg of his legendary personality. So most of you perhaps not know that he translated one of the most eloquent Urdu translation of English translation of Quran as pseudonym Shakir. And he was on to something. With that, he was getting the inspiration to cultivate and build the foundations and DNA of a new community, of a new nation. So many initiatives were taken either by his vision or by himself. Habib School, hospitals, orphanages, food services, refugee services, you name it. And when he died at a young age of only 54, not only his business, but essentially his name and his mark on this city, on this country, had already established itself as a philanthropist, as a benefactor. So the country of Pakistan issued a stamp in his memory in the year 2000, and he wasn't acknowledged as a great entrepreneur that he was, or a great banker that he was, but as a philanthropist, as a servant to this nation. So that's the first story of Muhammad Ali Habib. We thank you for that story. The second story is a little bleaker one, which is the creation of this country. It started off with overlap with Muhammad Ali Habib for about 11 years, and that country took some strange wrong turns. First one was a martial law in 1958. And as a result of that martial law, a second story started, a lot more stories started, but what is very relevant to us, which is the story of the downward spiral of Pakistani higher education. In 1961, Ayub Khan passed a decree that overnight Pakistani universities will only be limited to just doing engineering and medical, and students and faculty who were not, they thought were not really up to something or were not productive, were sent into what they call general. Now that resulted, fast forward few decades, resulting in Pakistan as one of the worst higher education countries in the world. Sixth largest country, enormous intellectual and human potential, but higher education being among the worst. Now that's where eventually in 2009, the first story of Muhammad Ali Habib and the second darker and a more difficult story of Pakistani higher education started to converge. And that's where the communities that I have just acknowledged, the Habib family and the Board of Governors and the Board of Directors, started to come together to put together a new story. And we are all in the middle of that story. That was the story and the beginning of the story of Habib University, right? In the backdrop of this unparalleled commitment to service, unparalleled commitment to creating and committing themselves to this nation, this new home that they had founded, Habibs converged on to one of the most difficult challenges, how to take on the ills which were now six decades old of Pakistani higher education. As I said, this story is incomplete. It's a very new story, right? We just started it not too long ago. You guys joined this story in 2014 and you're about to leave, right? But what my parting request to you, and probably I'm going to repeat it tomorrow, that don't ever lose contact with this story. This story has just begun, and you were lucky to get the box seat of being part of this story and knowing this story. And you have your life ahead of you to continue to remain a partner and a contributor and a co-writer of this story. So from today, we gave you the name in August of 2014 of co-founder. Let's change it a little bit. From tomorrow onwards, let's call you the co-writers of the Habib University story. You are the co-authors of it. Two great literary figures were mentioned in the speeches before. One was Robert Frost. I always remember the title of one of his poems, and this is for the graduating class. Happiness makes up in height what it lacks in length. Right? 4 years were not long, but they gave us pretty incredible highs of happiness. Right? So remember that. And then Noman, towards the end of his speech, quoted Ghalib, Dam har mauj mein hai halqa-e sadqam nahang. Dekhiye kya guzre hai qatre pe gohar hone tak. So tomorrow, this is just a teaser, we're going to talk, at least in my speech, I'm going to talk a little bit about not the gohar, but what are those sadqam and what are those nahangs. So stay tuned. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
A university can have all the right infrastructure and all the right resources, but without a great faculty such as ours, a university cannot excel. So tonight, we would like to take this opportunity to thank and recognize the founding faculty for their hard work and their dedication. I would request the Chancellor, Mr. Rafiq M. Habib, and Dr. Sabeen Javeri to join us on the stage. Mr. Wasif Rizvi, you're also invited.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for joining us today. It's a great night. Difficult to follow up after such great addresses by the president. So we will be paying a short tribute to our founding faculty, You'll be seeing some videos up here, and then we'll be presenting them with a souvenir. So I would request each faculty member to come up and receive their souvenir as their name is announced. Thank you. So we will now play the videos. Dr. Noman Naqvi. Dr. Naqvi is the director of the CLS program. He was also Habib's first dean. And as you can see, he's also very fashionable. Dr. Naqvi is the most color-coordinated faculty member on this campus. Dr. Waqar Saleem. Dr. Saleem is also my co-host tomorrow at the convocation. He is also one of the oldest faculty members at Habib, not in terms of age, definitely not, but in terms of Habib years. Dr. Hassan Ali Khan. Hassan is unfortunately not here tonight, but I'm sure he's with us in spirit. Hassan is always in good spirits, and Severin, Mrs. Hassan Ali as well, will be receiving his souvenir. Dr. Aaron Malwani. Dr. Malwani is one of the most liked members of faculty. So Aaron, we have to thank him for helping us set up the registrar department initially when the university was just starting out. And Aaron is now the interim director of the CND program, even though he's actually a great SDP teacher, one of the most liked teachers at Habib. Dr. Muhammad Shahid Sheikh. Dr. Sheikh is the interim dean of Dhanani School of Science and Engineering and also an associate professor. He actually joined the university in 2012 when the university was granted its charter. Ms. Saima Zaidi. Saima Zaidi is the director of Center for Media and Design. She's also one of the senior most members of faculty. I won't say oldest, I'll say senior most. Okay, want to go home alive. Saima is also known as the boss in her class and has initiated a number of design projects helping to integrate practice with theory. Dr. Anzir Khalik. Dr. Anzir Khalik is the Assistant Dean for Dhanani School of Science and Engineering and Director of Integrated Science and Mathematics and the Playground. Anzir is also our resident DJ, and lots of credit goes to him for the radio show. And Anzir also initiated the Habib TED Talks. Dr. Marcus is assistant professor for CND, and he's often seen walking around campus with a camera. Dr. Fahad Ali. Fahad is our program director for social development and policy. He's also a resident Marxist on campus. Dr. Shah Jamal Alam. So Dr. Shah Jamal, as we all know, is our registrar. He's actually, being the registrar is just one of his many hats, and all credit to him for teaching, managing the registrar's office, doing multiple things. I think Shah Jamal was born multitasking. And now our favorite, everyone's favorite, Dr. Asif Aslam Farooqi. Asif Saab, as he is better known among the faculty and students. Asif Saab is also a very much a literary personality, and has inspired many of us, many students, to read and write and become more creative in their everyday lives. So please thank us all in giving our founding faculty a big hand. They have inspired all of us, and I think tonight would probably be impossible without them. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Thank you, sirs, and thank you, Dr. Javeri.
It's now time to acknowledge the students for the best capstone and the Dean's Medals. For that, I would like to invite upon the stage Dean of Dhanani School of Science and Engineering, Dr. Muhammad Shahid Sheikh, the Program Director of Computer Science, Dr. Bakar Saleem, and the Program Director of Electrical Engineering, Dr. Amir Hassan.
So the Capstone Project is a great opportunity for Habib University students for applying the knowledge and the skills and the abilities gained over the 4 years program. So spanned over the last 1 year, 4 rigorous evaluations were made for the students' performances in the Capstone Project. And the project that was selected as the best showed excellence in 4 distinct domains. That was problem formulation and planning, creativity, design methodology, and most importantly, the completeness of a working prototype. I'm thankful to the Electrical Engineering Capstone Committee for showing due diligence and the hard work in the overall process. Based on the overall evaluations, the Dhanani School of Science and Engineering Best Capstone Project in Electrical Engineering goes to the project Malibot. I would now request the members of the group, Rabia Saleem, Muhammad Zoeb Ashraf, and Ariba Aziz Rajput, to come and receive the medal certificates from the dean. So I'd just like to tell you that over the span of just last 8 months, these students have developed a Malibot, which is a fully functional robot which automates the lawn maintenance and undertakes functions like cutting of the grass, sprinkling of water, and avoidance system. So it's a great job that they have done in the last 8 months. So give them a loud applause.
Thank you, Amir. In the computer science program, the Capstone Project represents to us a grand endeavor that represents the culmination of the students' 4-year journey with the program. It brings together their learning over their stay with us, and it's a yearning that represents the transition from one important stage of their life as they prepare to go on into the next. So we have therefore termed our final year project a Kavish. The best Kavish in computer science was voted on by the entire faculty based on the following criteria: the originality and utility of the work being undertaken, the extent to which the idea was executed, and the presentation of the work done. Before I present the award for Best Kavish, I would just briefly like to acknowledge the efforts of the CS Kavish Committee, Dr. Umair Khan, who was later joined with Dr. Sayyedza Saleha Raza, who took over the administration of the Kavish. And the Best Kavish goes to Amin Shiraz Gilani and Sayyed Afan Aslam. Their work was on describing the complexity of quantum finite automata using techniques from communication complexity. They presented their work earlier this year in one of the leading conferences on quantum information, which is a quantum information processing conference which took place in the Netherlands. There's one more. There was actually a tie, and maybe the group over there knows, or they can guess who the other group is for Best Kavish. The tie is with Playlab by Anusha Fatma and Sumbal Zaira. Playlab is an interactive 3D storytelling application that responds to free air hand gestures using the Leap Motion controller. Frustrated by the default API, they wrote their own engine to recognize gestures using techniques from machine learning. And their project represents a proof of concept that combines child-computer interaction with hand gestures.
Thank you, sirs.
We now present the best thesis, capstone, and the Dean's Medals for the School of Arts, Humanities, and Social Sciences. To present the awards, I would like to invite upon the stage the Dean, Dr. Craig Phelan, Program Director of Social Development and Policy, Dr. Fahd Ali, and the Program Director of Communication and Design, Dr. Aaron Mulvaney.
May the fourth be with you. The Program of Communication and Design is delighted to offer a tie. We had exceptional projects this year in our first year, and the three awards that we'll be giving this year were the top jury scores for external jurors. And once we measured in the individual faculty grades, they were so close in score as to be indistinguishable. These projects are all amazing for very different reasons. They all take different approaches to design, and I'm not sure who you have first there, but I would like to first award for her deeply personal and beautifully designed poetry and photographic work, We, Zoha Jabbar. Our second award goes to a very different project, one with a more external outlook. It's Sakina Ijaz's work with raising awareness on organ donation, Infinity. And our final work does everything that we in CND want our students to do. It was deeply interdisciplinary. It engaged with local folklore, with local storytelling. It goes to Talha Keher for Dastani Karachi. I think I jumped the gun on this one a little bit. I was supposed to do this with Waqar Saleem because we're giving an interdisciplinary award. My apologies. If we can have Waqar up here real quick for a photo. I'm just so excited to introduce all of these. And Fatin Nawaz. I'm sorry, Fatin.
Congratulations, Dr. Fadali. Please announce the best thesis.
I think this is overwhelming, and I think it's overwhelming, and I think also it's immensely. I think it's an immense honor as well for me to stand over here and sort of, you know, announce these three awards. The type of work that STP students have done in their last year is phenomenal. It's amazing. The type of insights that they've brought in through their projects, some of them are really, graduate student level work. And I hope the awards that we have selected, these students consider academia as a viable career for themselves and pursue these projects in their later careers as well. SDP, the program decided to award distinction to three students' theses for their outstanding work. The distinction was awarded to students whose work shed new light on an issue of civic and social importance and allow readers to arrive at a new theoretical understanding of it. We gave three awards. The first one goes to Moiza Salahuddin for her thesis entitled, so I would like to read about their work. It's really, really good, and I would like to read about other people's work as well, so just bear with me for a moment. Moiza's thesis is entitled Sharing Economy Disrupted, the Case of Ride-Hailing Apps in Karachi. Moiza's thesis shed new light on our understanding of how the sharing economy models may not disrupt the existing mode of doing business. This has serious implications for income distribution in our society. Her work theorizes that unlike the case of US and Europe, the underlying characteristic of Industry 4.0 are reversed as it is translated onto the model of prevailing capitalism. Further, it suggests an assimilation rather than disruption of conventional businesses. This has struck implications for income inequalities in our society. So Moiza Salahuddin, if you can come to the stage and receive your. The next award goes to Neha Panjwani. Her work entitled Exploring the Subjective Experiences of Khwaja Sera on Karachi Public Buses. Neha's work allows us to understand the phenomenological experience of an important community that, despite being publicly visible, exists on the far end of social margins. Her work on the subjective experience of Khwaja Seras in the public transportation landscape of Karachi forces us to think about the collective punishment that we inflict on people who deem social outcasts and redundant. Her research tackles the complex dynamics of their inclusion, exclusion from public transit spaces, resulting in a differentiated mobility experience, one that not only brings to the fore their existential legitimacy or their systematic oppression, but also located in contextual negotiation of their difference. Thank you very much for doing this remarkable work. SDP's last award for the night goes to Sameen Nizamuddin. His thesis entitled Where Is My Home? Identity, Belonging, Performativity of Second Generation Afghan Refugee Youth in Pakistan looks at how issues of identity and belonging among second generation Afghan migrants make them express and perform their identities in and out of their households in various social contexts within Pakistan. In an age where xenophobia world over rears its ugly head, Sameer's work reminds us of the importance of the need to work towards a politics of inclusion to build a society that embraces all people regardless of their ethnicity, race, color. Thank you very much, Sameer, for doing a wonderful dissertation. Thank you very much.
Congratulations. I'd request the dean and the program directors to stay on stage. Dr. Fahd, if you please come to the podium to announce the dean's medals.
Okay, so I don't know who is this going to be. I have no idea. I'm just going to, I guess this is my Oscar moment. So this is the SDP medal, and the winner of the Dean's Medal for the School of Arts, Humanities, and Social Sciences in Social Development and Policy is Sumer Nizamuddin.
Congratulations to me, Dr. Aaron Mulvaney, if you would kindly announce the Dean's Medal for CND.
Thank you. I'll try to make this one less awkward than the last one. The winner of the Dean's Medal for the School of Arts, Humanities, and Social Sciences in Communication Studies and Design, and I haven't looked at the bottom yet, so this is really exciting for me, Sadia Asad Pathan.
Thank you all. We now present the Dean's Medals Awards for the Dhanani School of Science and Engineering. And for that, I would like to request upon the stage the Dean, Dr. Shahid Sheikh, the Program Director of CS, Waqar Saleem, and the Program Director of Electrical Engineering, Dr. Amir.
So the Dean's Medal for the Electrical Engineering Program goes to Ariba Aziz Rajput.
Mr. Dhanani, please come on the stage.
Congratulations, Ariba. Dr. Waqar Saleem, kindly join us on the podium.
So the Dean's Medal, as I'm sure you're all aware, is based on the highest academic achievement within the program.
It is not just academic achievement in computer science courses, it is academic achievement in all the courses, which represents how well the student was able to integrate knowledge from different disciplines into their major. And the medal goes to, I think before I should before I introduce the student, there's something I've been wanting to say for a long time. Why was the erythrocyte running? Because it was in Anas. Anas Masood.
Thank you all. I'd request Dr. Bakkar and Dr. Shahid Sheikh to kindly stay on stage.
To present awards from the student government, I would like to invite Dr. Talat Azhar, Vice President, Institutional Effectiveness and Student Affairs, and Ms. Aram Sever, the Vice President of the current student government, to join us on the stage.
Honorable Chancellor Rafiq M. Habib, Distinguished Board of Governors, respected President Wasif Rizvi, esteemed faculty and guests, and our co-founders, good evening. I'd like to talk about a little about the student government and what it does. The mission of the student government is to represent the interest of the student body through initiatives, programs, and services that enrich students' lives at Habib University, originating from the five pillars of YOSIN, that is excellence, service, passion, beauty, and respect. With the help of Office of Student Life, we strive to create opportunities for students to clarify and challenge their values, potential, roles, and responsibilities within the university, in the greater communities, and the global society. The idea of the student government started with the class of 2018 itself and has gained more importance since then. And this is the perfect time to appreciate their efforts for everything that they have done for us. The student government is extremely delighted to announce awards that celebrate their efforts beyond the classroom. Starting with the first award, which is the Leadership Award, this award recognizes each students who take initiative and demonstrate inclusive leadership that impacts their academics, work, and community environments. The Leadership Award for this year goes to Anas Masood. Congratulations, Anas. Our second award is the Service Award, which exemplifies the spirit of volunteerism through participation in the community. It recognizes the student's service-based contribution to the university and the community beyond it. The Service Award for this year goes to Sayyid Muhammad Hassan Naqvi. Thank you, Hassan, for everything that you have done for us. Last but not the least is the Advocacy for Social Change Award. It celebrates inspiring and strategic campaigns that raise public awareness on development topics towards positive social change. The Advocacy for Social Change Award goes to Sana Rizwan Gondal. I'd like to thank Dr. Talat for her mentorship for our student government. I'd also like to congratulate all the winners thank you for being an inspiration for all of us. With that being said, best of luck to the class of 2018. We hope that you keep on inspiring people throughout your lives. Thank you.
Thank you, Arham. Dr. Azhar, may I please request you to stay on the stage?
And may I please request President Wasir Rizvi to come on stage for the awarding of the President's Medal.
Chancellor Rafiq M. Habib, members of the Board of Governors, President Wasir Rizvi, deans, faculty and staff, guests and students, good evening. As the first liberal arts and sciences university in Pakistan, Habib University was established with specific goals to bring about a transformative change in the educational landscape of Pakistan. To achieve this goal, the university worked with our global partners to establish and adhere to the highest standards. The unique interdisciplinary approach that the university adopted provides our students an intellectually stimulating environment which promotes creativity and exchange of ideas while challenging them to excel academically. And needless to say, we hold our students to very high standards. Our next award, the President's Medal, is given in recognition of highest overall academic achievement across all programs in both schools over 4 years. Tonight's winner is no stranger to academic excellence. Having appeared on the Dean's List 4 times and the President's List 2x, she's an example of what hard work and dedication can accomplish. Ladies and gentlemen, it gives me great pleasure to announce that the winner of the 2018 President's Medal is Sadia Asad Pathan. Now it's time to announce the valedictorian. The student chosen to be the valedictorian is one who has exhibited scholarship of the highest level and achieved the highest overall CGPA in both schools and across all programs. It is my pleasure to announce that the class of 2018 valedictorian is Sadia Asad Pathan. And let there be no mistake, Sadia will be practicing her speech tonight. And finally, there is one medal for which the recipient has yet to be announced, and you will all have to wait for that until tomorrow. The Chancellor's Medal is awarded to a graduating student who has not only excelled academically, but who has embodied the philosophy of Yosin by striving for constant self-cultivation in 5 key areas, beauty, passion, respect, service, and excellence. The recipient of this award will be announced tomorrow during the convocation ceremony.
Thank you, Dr. Talat, and thank you, President.
It's my privilege and honor to call upon the stage the Chancellor, Mr. Rafiq M. Habib, to share his thoughts with us.
I was actually going to speak to you all tomorrow. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. It has been an absolute honor and a humbling experience. I'm lost for words. I am grateful to Almighty Allah for bringing us here today together. And all I can say is I look forward to getting to know you all better, hoping that you all will continue to stay in touch and continue to help improve the university from day to day. You will have to wait till tomorrow to hear the rest of my speech. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. If you could please remain on the stage. May I request tonight's award winners, member of the Board of Governors, the President, the Deans, and the Program Directors, the Registrar, and the founding faculty awarded tonight to kindly join us on the stage for a group photo. All the members of the Board of Governors, please. The Deans. Program Directors. The Registrar. The founding faculty awarded tonight. The Certificate Award winners. They should be on the stage, please. The ones who received a certificate today.